Hello everyone. Welcome back to Arx Fatalis. So I'm still investigating the dark ritual that took place in the castle, apparently related to the murder of Fallon Orpoplanix. So I need to question people, but I suppose I'm kind of doing that along the way of just exploring the castle, because that's mostly what I'm doing right now. I just want to find out where everything is, find my room, brew some potions. So probably going to be gathering some information along the way, but in the meantime, while doing that, let's just explore around. So let's talk to this astronomer here.
I am the new astronomer. I was assistant to poor Fallon Orpoplanix, and since his death, I do my best to look after the observatory.
Well, you're doing a fine job here. He has lots of things to look over. Like this empty bench in this tiny, awkwardly placed chest.
Sweeberis, what can you tell me about the rituals? Do you know who killed Fallon Orpoplanix?
Really, I don't know what you're talking about. You know, I'm still just a novice in my art, and on top of that, I hate violence.
Okay, he just shot to the absolute top of my most wanted, or most suspicious list. And what the hell do you mean, I have no idea what you're talking about? You just told me you replaced poor Orpoplanix. Which implies that you know that he got murdered. And your smooth voice... Your smooth... voice does not convince me of your innocence. I have no idea what you're talking about. I have absolutely nothing to hide. Sure, sure.
What did the stars tell you?
The current astral configuration is fascinating.
Okay. That doesn't answer my question. What did they tell you? That doesn't answer my question at all.
What did the stars tell you?
My job demands high levels of concentration, you know.
That's why you're spending your time staring at nothing walking around? Okay. You're kind of crazy. I wonder if you'd mind if I try to open this.
Locked.
Well, he's not looking, so... Quickly, quickly.
Not really a very successful attempt.
One more try. Come on. You can do it. God damn it.
I think I've damaged my tools.
I think your brain is damaged.
What did the stars tell you?
The current astral configuration is fascinating.
Yeah, I think he did it. He did it. I'm just gonna say it. He did it. I love the fact that my, like, magic-imbued armor doesn't just glow in the inventory. As you can see, the image glows. But it actually glows in the real world, so I'm actually walking around with glowing armor. I'm actually glowing. Like, I don't even need a nightlight, I just glow. I glow in the dark. How awesome is that? Ah, yes, that's a librarium. Oh yeah, some potions. Yeah, you know what, let's brew some potions right now, actually. Let's see how many I can make with my relatively low... object knowledge skill. Actually, no, it's not that low. Wait, what? Okay, I leveled up again at some point. How is it that I never know when I level up? Okay. Well. What do I want to spend it on? Maybe more strength? I'm gonna go with strength. I do want to wear that super good armor. Okay, casting? Maybe I should get casting up to 40. So yeah, if I get it up to 40, it'll give me access to a new tier of magic spells, I believe, but I don't know what is, you know, what's waiting for me. And whether I would even find it useful, because as far as I know, 30 is what you need to get the fireball spell. Which is apparently very important, and it's already to that, but, Alright, well, let's get this up to 40. And let's just put the rest in... Let's go with object knowledge. Because I'm about to brew potions. So, there we go. See if any new spells popped up. I don't know if they pop up automatically. No, apparently not. Did I ever figure out how to do night vision? I don't think I did. I still don't get the left rune here. The one that pops up down here. What the hell is that? Like, I don't see it on the runes that I have in the top right. Is it just oriented in a different way? What the hell is it? It's confusing. Actually, yeah, it is just oriented in a different way, isn't it? It's this one. I think. So it's that one and this one. Okay. Okay, there we go. Holy crap, that burns my eyes. Ow. Ow. I suppose this isn't very useful unless I'm actually in the dark. So, please go away. Thank you. Here. Have some dough. Oh, maybe there's a magic force field over these bars. And that's how it's able to keep the rat inside despite the fact that it could blatantly fit through. Because even my bread dough won't go through. Okay, took pretty much everything. Still a potion left there. I don't have any room in my inventory, though. Except two slots. How did I get two slots free? Thought it was full. Let's read this. Making your own potions is both easy and straightforward. All it takes is meticulousness and patience. First, you must find an empty bottle. Next, you need the reagent specific to each potion. When you have this, crush it into a fine powder in a pestle and mortar, then put it into an empty vial, heat the mixture with a still, the potion is ready. Okay, so yeah. Crush it, already done, put the powder in a bottle, already done, just need to use this on the distillery, and I'll have a potion. Okay. Is there recipes? Powdered lily. Right, blue for mana potion, makes sense. Purple is antidotes. White powder is invisibility potions, which I don't have any. Actually, if I grind this up, I probably will have. Oh no, here's some powder. Just looks like a different pile than the rest of them. Yeah, let's process the rest of the ingredients. I just want to sell a bunch of potions. Like, I think I can make a killing on it. Okay, orange powder makes healing potions. Wow. I have enough here to make so many different potions. Okay, let's get brewing. I think my limiting factor is gonna be the freaking bottles. There we go, poisonous potion. Got a nice stack of those. Of course, some of these I probably can't make because I probably don't have the skill to do it. But, let's see. Let's try a healing potion. There we go. Let's try an invisibility potion.
I do not yet have the skill to do that.
Ah, 70 object knowledge, okay. Let's try... what is green? Is that the poison? It was green, wasn't it?
A real alchemist.
A real alchemist. It's like he's telling that to himself. I'm a real alchemist now. My father said I never could be one, but I'm a real alchemist. That'll show him. It's too bad he's been dead for 5 years. What have I not tried? Purple? Oh yeah, purple's a cure. Poison, okay. Let's see, I've not made a mana potion.
I do not yet have the skill to do that.
Okay, 60 for that. What is it currently at? 50? Yep, 50. Okay, I think I tried all the colors, didn't I? Snowdrop, yeah, purple, green. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so I have like a bajillion green powder. So let's actually make a bunch of poison potions and just sell them. I am going to be rich. Ah, I like that sound. You know, one thing I do wish, though, is I kind of wish it was as hands-on and interactive as baking. Like, maybe you actually drag the vial out to the table or something to cook it on a, you know, like an old-style Bunsen burner or something. Something more than just a sound effect. You know, like the bread, the way it rises up. It's very cool. Okay, any more bottles? Those can stack. I really need to sort my inventory, like, super, super bad. Okay, there's some more bottles in here. And I think I have enough bottles on me that have, like, potions.
I do not yet have the skill to do that.
That I probably don't actually need the empty bottles for myself. I mean, I'll get an empty bottle from wine. Got a bunch of these. Yeah, I should be fine. Okay, so now just to help with my inventory problem, I'm just going to stuff all of my alchemical ingredients in here. Is there an easy way to do this? No. There's not. Okay, I'm going to sort my inventory and I'll be right back. Alright, there we go. All of my alchemical powders and unfinished potions and empty bottles and my pestle and mortar have been stuffed away in a rather colorful fashion. It's actually very pretty. So I saved a bunch of room in my inventory, and I also kind of sorted this by putting all my food items up here in the top left, all my potions down here, general valuables here, like gems and stuff like that, and all of my more useful active items and my wordy stuff down here. Okay. Let's go exploring. Actually, I want to do a little bit of reading. I don't want to read all of these at one time. It's a bit much, but there's one in particular. Yeah, the Guild of Travelers. By the Sage Dor... Is it an N? Dornell? Oh, it's even really short. Yeah, I want to know more about the Guild of Travelers, because they actually sound pretty cool. The Guild of Travelers was the first institution created after the death of Arx's son. Its origins stem from a handful of diehard survivors, who did not want to join the rest of the population underground. These rare survivors developed techniques for resisting the cold by ingesting alchemists' drugs. They built their own shelters from ice and bred dogs which were also able to resist the cold. They were joined by other men and women who were not afraid of the cold and who also wanted to venture out to other cities. Out of these journeys was born the Guild of Travelers, which is now the only remaining means of communication between the underground cities. They are always well respected and eagerly welcomed, for they are the only people able to bring news from outside. Yeah, I wonder if at some point in the game you actually get to go outside, maybe. Maybe I get to join the Guild of Travelers, or maybe I have to bring news to another place. It just sounds really cool. It sounds exciting. Let's see, if there's anything else that catches my eye. Oh, History of Arx, that's probably quite long. Not super long, moderately long. The Kings of Arx. The Races. Yeah, let's look at some of the races. Holy crap, this one's really long. I love how much detail there is to the game world. Very cool. Let's see if I can find the snake people. The Sisters of Edernium. Is that them? Yeah. Yeah, the Sisters of Edernium. The origins of them are a mystery. They look like hybrids between women and snakes. Their skin is covered in scales. There seems to be no males in their race, and we know nothing about how they reproduce. They are very gifted in the use of magic, making them the best magicians in Arx. According to certain legend, they were involved in the very origins of magic. They have always been very close to the human race, helping them at every difficult stage of their development. During their migration, the sisters promised to help the king of the humans, and created underground plants to feed the inhabitants and their livestock. Know your gods and demons. This might be important for the ritual. What about Akba? Oh, here it is. Yeah, Akba. Created on Cult, evil god. Named the god of destruction because he destroyed Kultk. It's so pleasant to say. Kultk. Destroyed it completely. He was initially adored by his followers because of the help he gave them during their wars and conflicts. Okay, evil god. Makes sense, given that people are apparently sacrificing humans to them. Yeah. I'll read some more later. Take more of a look around, I want to sell my stuff, and I want to find my freaking room. I've already been this way, right? Yeah, that's the observatory. And I think I fully explored the opposite direction as well, so I think I need to advance into the king's chamber and then go up the stairs. Yeah, it's where the ritual took... That's where the ritual took place, it's where the creepy chicken is, that's the guard's post. Let's take these books. I'm gonna stuff them somewhere else. Someone just drank something. What did you drink? I don't see no bottles. What? What are you drinking? Or are you just gulping because I make you nervous? Why would I make you nervous?
The Ilsets. Who the hell are they?
Yeah, so my room is probably up here. I also need to find...
This snake woman makes me sick.
That doesn't look right. That is a blatant secret door. Look at that. Someone didn't do a very good job. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, I need to find Orban Planetrix? Dominipa Planetrix? What the fuck is his name? Orboplanix? I need to find his room. Because he's apparently linked to the rituals, and I have a password to something of his, 288. Okay, this might be my room. Apparently not. Oh, there we go. Om Shigar. That's the key. I wish I could just, like, name the freaking key. I mean, it just says a little metal key. Like, can't I name it and say room key? I guess not. A bag. Can I actually use this to increase my sword space? Where'd it go? What?
Who the hell are
they? I'm confused. Where the hell did it go? What the fuck's my bag?
War, huh?
I don't understand. Did it, like, extend my inventory? I mean, there's an arrow here, but I can't click it. I think it's just saying I can make it go down. No, that's on every side of the screen. Those don't mean anything. Where the fuck did it go? I'm checking in his pants. For a bag. Oh, there it is. Gee, what the hell? It scared me. Okay, there it is. Right-click on the inventory belt to show what's inside all your bags. Oh my god, I doubled my fucking inventory space! Oh, that's beautiful! Oh my god, that is beautiful. Okay, so... Let's put... I don't even need to store my stuff anymore. Yeah, I don't even need to store my stuff. I could honestly keep pretty much everything on me. But let's keep a bit of room for collecting stuff to sell. So I'm going to go ahead and put all of my reading material in my second bag, and my keys. Because that is stuff that I use very infrequently. And this too, because I'm not going to be using that for a while, I think. Oh shit, it automatically puts in the first one. It does. It's fine. Okay. Sweet. Sweet, 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 sweet. That is awesome. That is such a load off my mind. Why can't I put this thing down? That one doesn't stack, right? No, it doesn't. Kinda wish there was an auto sword button. Alright, there we go. Okay. Wow. That is seriously a weight off my mind. I feel better now. As if I've been holding in a piss for like 20 hours and I've finally just relieved myself. You know the feeling. One more day. What the fuck is this? Okay, that's easy. Right. I'm wondering why you can even close that if there's a switch on both sides. What's the point? Yeah, I'm guessing the function of those weird teleportal-looking things will probably become clear later on. Lord Lunchire. Oh, if I can get into the king's room. Don't look. Are you looking? Okay, I need to buy more tools. I ain't got no lockpicks. Do you ever feel like someone's just looking at you? Do you ever get that feeling? I never do. That is the astronomer's place. I want to get into all of their places. I just need more tools. Here we go. Phalen Orbiplanix. Is this his key? Yes, it is. Okay. Look at that ceiling. That is beautiful and strange.
Locked.
Okay, gotta look around for... What the f... Okay, gotta look around for secret stuff. Hello? Telekinesis. Yes. Wait, what is that? Aha! And I have the password. Okay, it's 288.
Far too quiet. I don't like it.
What? You're telling me I got the riddle wrong? You gotta be kidding me.
This job is boring. I should have accepted Gary's offer.
But I went through it multiple times and it seemed so simple. To be honest, I didn't feel too good about the solution to the riddle because it felt too easy. But then I thought I was just kind of overthinking it. There's no, like, enter. I don't need to enter the password, do I? No, it looks like it just works. Or it doesn't. As is the case here. I'll just cover over my shame.
It never happened.
Okay, what the hell am I missing? 6 becomes 4 when you take the first from it. Yeah, so the first one is definitely two, right? Six becomes four when you take the first from it. When you take two from six, it becomes four. Yeah, the first one's two. The first multiplied by the second makes the last... Okay, once again, that's irrelevant. The last multiplied by the first makes 16. Once again, that's 8. So the last one is 8. 8 multiplied by 2 is 16. The first multiplied by the second makes the last.
This job is boring. I should have accepted Gary.
What am I missing? I'm going to think about this. Okay, so the middle number is actually 4. Yeah, I see what I did wrong. So the first one is, of course, 2, because 6 becomes 4 when you take the first from it. So if you take 2 from 6, it becomes 4. And then the last multiplied by the first makes 16. So the last one is 8. 2 times 8 is 16. The problem is with the middle one. I didn't do it correctly. So the first 2 multiplied by the second makes the last. So the error I was making is, for some reason, I was thinking of the last as being 16, but no, the last is 8. So the first multiplied by the second makes the last means 2 times 4 equals 8. So it's 2, 4, 8. Gotcha. Bingo!
Ah, here we are. Fallon's precious notebook. I think it is time to call the council together.
Very well. Now that all the members of the council are present, let us begin. Felnor, what have you found in Fallon Orbiplanix's notes?
Let me see... Fallon mentions something about the guard, Urzog. He says he saw him practicing dark rituals involving animal sacrifices. Perhaps it was Urzog who was behind Fallon's murder. Or perhaps it was even the High Priest of the Cult of Akba. Listen to this. I discovered the existence of a cult which wishes to invoke Akba onto Arx.
Always suspicious of that, Urzog. Guards, throw Urzog into the cells!
Felnor, who is this Akba I heard you speak of?
Akba is a powerful devil, the god of destruction, that this cult is evidently trying to invoke and bring back to Arx. It would be blasphemy to allow this act to be perpetrated, and a total disaster for every living being on our planet.
Yes, yes, here, listen to the next bit. This evening I shall contact the Noden to ask for their help.
The Noden?
The Noden is the dimension which regulates the existence of gods. They maintain the universal equilibrium by preventing an imbalance in the power of gods.
If Fallon really had been able to contact the Noden, it is possible they may have sent an emissary here to stop the coming of Akba.
Hint, it's me.
Emissary?
These emissaries are creatures of pure energy when they are on the Noden. They are sent to cut off the energy channels which might drive the gods out of their dimension. I have heard amazing tales of emissaries who have the strength of 100 men, or who can perform the highest forms of magic. Others who are invincible. These emissaries are called guardians.
Somewhere in the fortress is a cult which recites impious prayers to a fragment of a meteorite made entirely of a material called Koltk. This rock is said to have come from the place where Akba was born. Normally, this substance is indestructible. In truth, Felnor, only a guardian of the Noden could destroy this meteor.
How could one of these guardians stop the incarnation of a god just by destroying a piece of rock?
It is the impious prayers of the priests and their hideous sacrifices which are focused by the meteor. It provides a channel of energy for Akba, who, when he has gathered enough, will be able to complete his incarnation in Arx. If that happens, destruction and suffering will be unleashed upon us. We must find and destroy this meteorite at any cost.
How shall we find this guardian?
I have a fragment of Kaltic in my laboratory, which may be of great assistance in finding him.
Let's be clear about one thing. We know that the cult of Akbar has a great presence in Arx, and that it is gaining power. Luckily, we were able to stop Urzog, the cult's high priest, before it was too late. But other worshippers could still invoke Akbar. We must find this famed guardian of the Noden as soon as possible.
In addition, the war with the Ilsids is very troubling, Majesty. What should we do about it?
Carlo, we need a solid plan of defense. I fear the worst. Nobody knows exactly what these Ilsids are or who commands them. Guards, bring me the fragment of Kaltic. Amshigar, while our army is facing the Ilsids, we will need your help to find this legendary guardian. I cannot deny that this task will be harsh and lengthy. In fact, we have no idea what the guardian will look like, or even if it is already among us.
Oh my God.
I have faith in your capabilities.
Here is the stone, Your Majesty.
Good. Put it on the table. Take this stone, Amshigar. It is a small thing, but the Guardian is the only one who is capable of destroying this fragment of meteor. Above all, take great care. Great heavens!
What a surprise!
Welcome, Guardian. Allow me to explain your next mission. You know the rules of the Noden, the dimension of gods and demon princes. No being of power is permitted to leave this dimension, but Akbar is preparing to invade a world called Arx. A group of his followers is presently trying to invoke him. You know that this must not be. We cannot fight Akbar from here, for we can impose nothing on the gods. So we shall send you to destroy this cult which worships him, and without the adulation of followers, his power will diminish to acceptable levels.
I shall destroy this cult, Master.
It will be no simple task. For this mission, we shall confer upon you a specific skill to allow you to destroy the Kaltic rock which is linked to Akbar's power. It is impervious to mortal attack. This rock is the source of the problem, as it channels the energy given by Akbar's followers. Soon, Akbar will have enough energy to enable him to complete his incarnation on Arx.
I understand, Master. Well, I have a contact in Arx.
Your contact died during the transmission of this message. You will have to find your own way when you get there. This is extremely troublesome, as the shock of the passage is disastrous for a guardian's memory. You may be disoriented for a while before your memory returns and you recall this conversation. But there is no other way. Prepare yourself. You are about to be transported. I will bring you back when you have completed your mission.
But that means that Amshigar is...
The Guardian. It all makes sense to me now, and especially his constant desire to help others. I am honored to meet you, Guardian.
Touching this stone has enlightened my mind. I was sent here to stop the coming of Akbar. I must act without delay. First, I need to gain access to the secret temple. There I shall destroy the stone by simply touching it.
May the wisdom of the Noden guide you, Amshigar.
Don't let us delay you further.
I feel so bad for the voice actors. Having to actually say Orboplanix and Kaltic. You could even hear them when they said it. Kaltic. 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 It's a horrible word. Why would anyone make that word? This is some of the most hilariously terrible storytelling. It's like storytelling that's so bad, it's actually kind of good. I mean, could the reveal that I'm the Guardian have been any more obvious? I didn't actually know that I was the Guardian, by the way. Like, if I even got to this point in the game when I played it before, I did not even remember it. I had no idea, but the storytelling was, like, bludgeoning me over the head with its... with its allusions, if you want to call it that, to the fact that I'm the Guardian. Like, you know, we don't know where this Guardian is, or even if he's among us right now. At that point, the camera might as well have just turned Amshigar and just, like, looked at his face for a couple seconds right after the king said that. I mean, come on. Oh my god. It's so cheesy. Let's see. Now I should find the secret way into the Temple of Akba and destroy the meteor. I don't even know where that is. Where is this temple? Where in the hell am I even supposed to go now? Apparently the way is a secret, so... yeah. I don't know. But I do know I need to sell my stuff, and perhaps I use one of those weird teleportation things to get me there? I don't know. I swear, somebody's like snorting cocaine during that cutscene. Like, I kept hearing somebody just go like... or something, some extremely loud and strange noise. So weird. So weird. Let's go see if I can speak with the guard that was put in jail.
Forgive me, my darling.
Oh no.
Herzog, I presume. Tell me why you killed Fallon Orbiplanix. Are you the high priest of the cult of Akba?
Oh, mercy! Don't kill me! Oh, guardian of the light, I am no priest! I swear it! The rituals were only to bring my dear wife back from the dead!
Tell me more, Herzog.
They contacted me, but always remained hidden in shadow. The priests assured me that if I prayed to Akba and performed the rituals, my wife would return to me. But it was all lies. Oh, please have mercy on my wretched soul!
Give me another good reason to spare your life, mortal.
I can help you. The entrance to their temple is through the metal door in the yellow tulip. They gave me the password. Fat Kapel.
Ah! I'm really glad I talked to you. I seem to keep stumbling upon the answer to where I need to go accidentally. Because otherwise I would have just been wandering around like a jackass.
I swear to you, on my wife's grave, that I will repay my treachery by doing whatever I can to help rid Arx of that blasted cult.
The drama of what you just said was kind of lessened by the fact that you turned my back for the majority of it. I mean, turned your back to me for the majority of it. Fuck, I messed that up. I'm just gonna go now. Under the tavern, and he gave me the secret word to enter. Okay. By the way, I'm still looking for this Oliver to put my emerald in his chest. Also, that really sounds like the world's shittiest euphemism. It's like, yeah, I'm gonna put my emerald in his chest, if you know what I mean. Hi. It's more of the... shit, what were they called? I don't actually remember what they were called. Adurnian? Something. Like that.
I hate to have to repeat this once again, Lunshire. Find Krahals and return it to us, or you will regret your slackness.
What? He's talking, but I don't hear anything. Speak up! I can't hear you, King!
Enough. The Order has no interest in your sob stories. Results are the only thing that can save you from the expression of our disappointment. Now,
I'll get my best men on it.
Now I can't hear her. What the hell is... what is going on?
I don't understand any of this. What was this conversation about?
What the f... Listen. No offense, but I think it would be best if you stayed out of this. This concerns something internal to the kingdom.
What is going on with the cutscene dialogue? Amshigar was like whispering there. His voice was so low in the mix. It's like, what?
Don't let us delay you further.
This snake woman makes me sick.
Okay, well, I suppose there's no reason to check out the portal, since I know that's not going to take me there, so let's just go... Oh, hi.
Don't let my presence here disturb you, Amshigar. Your identity has been confirmed to me. The prophecy was right. Now it's up to you to fulfill it. Although I would not wish to guide your destiny, Amshigar, let me suggest a valuable aid. Follow me, and I will teach you the art of walking through the walls in this kingdom. On each of the kingdom's levels, my sisters have set up a similar room. To use these portals, stand in front and chant the spell, Activate Portal. Then, you will be able to travel to any of the other portals you have activated beforehand. May your faith in the gods be strength in the face of darkness.
Okay, good to know. And what did she say the chant was? Activate portal? That doesn't sound like much of a chant. That just sounds like a sentence. Couple new ones. Is it not actually a spell? Like, how do I do it?
I feel tired.
Oh wow, it actually doesn't show up as a spell. You have to just read it? Yeah, it's Megaspacium. Megaspacium! Massive space! Whoa, dude.
Bet I can take two Ilsids on my own.
So this one, and this one, Mega Spacium. I swear she said open portal, not Mega Spacium, but whatever. And then, shit, what was this? There we go. Yep, that's the one. Okay, just gonna activate the other ones. So I can't use this right now, right? Well, there's something very weird about the way this light looks. Whoa.
I should have been cook. That's easier.
Anyway. Oh, aren't you the shopkeeper?
I'm sorry. But I won't be able to sell you anything today. I'm gonna have to close up the stall now.
Wait, what?
Are you in need of a healer?
No, I'm not sick. It's my little girl, Shaney. She's been missing since yesterday.
Oh,
and I'm
no, she went into the crypt.
Missing?
She was playing at the other side of the square, near the jeweler's. And she never came back to the stall. Nobody has seen her, and the guards are far too busy dealing with the Ilsid attacks to do anything about it.
I will discover what has happened to your little girl.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you. You are heaven sent, traveler.
Let's just not tell her the fact that I'm only helping her because I want to sell my potions to her. No, I'm just kidding. I'm doing it because I'm a nice guy. Actually, I might be able to sell her stuff anyway. Yeah, I think I can. Okay. Sweet, so how much are these worth? 91 each. That's a pretty good profit. How many do I want to sell? I don't think I need that many. And these are worth 122. Yeah, so it looks like basically the harder it is to make, you know, the more knowledge it requires to make it, the more money you can get from it. So let's just sell all of these. Boom. I've got 2,000 coins now. Oh man, yeah, the price I'm getting for these is actually really bad. I'm getting less than half of what it costs to buy it. Which I suppose is because my skill is not very good. Which one is it? Intuition. Yeah, it's intuition. Yeah, so if my intuition was better, I can get some better prices for stuff, but it's fine. Alright, do you have anything I want to buy other than tools? Because I definitely want the tools. I'd like some more armor as well, but I don't think I need it. Alright, let's just grab some tools. I almost want two of these. Yeah, actually I do want two of these. A key ring. A key ring? Does that do what I think it does? I want that now. If that is what I think it does, then that is amazing. Hold on. Holy fucking hell, that's the world's biggest keyring! What the hell? Look at that! Looks more like a life preserver. A kind of thin one, but Jesus Christ, that's not a key ring. That's like a fucking key planet. Yes, you can put keys on it! Oh my god, that is so cool. And the image even updates to reflect how many keys you have on it. That is so fucking cool! Look at that. That is amazing. I want all RPGs to have that system. You have to buy a keyring, it just makes sense. Although it doesn't make any sense why it would be so damn expensive. It costs about the same as an entire set of tools for lockpicking, when all it is a ring of metal, but whatever. That is so cool. Alright, so she said near the jewelers, right? This requires key, which I do not have. Unless I can blow it up. Shit, I messed it up. No, that seems right. My god, that's loud. And it didn't work. Alright, where's the jewelers? Right here? Tefayek? Excuse me.
Greetings, stranger. I'm Tefayek, the jeweler. Please feel free to browse my wares. If something interests you, pick it up. If you have something to sell, drop it in the chest, and I'll make you an offer.
Because that's exactly how it works in the real world. You just drop your stuff in the chest, and they give you money.
Please, look at my wares, and help yourself.
Okay, so you I can sell my gemmy stuff to. Sweet. Alright, let's see how much money I can get for my stuff. Oh man, I'm gonna get so much money. I'm really hoping I don't need these for any recipes. I'm pretty sure I don't. Yep, 117 for the emeralds. Keeping in mind, I want to keep one for the treasure hunt quest. 122 for the diamonds. I don't know if Anakar's rock is useful, so I'm just going to keep it, just in case. Alright, let's keep one of these. Okay, I've got 3,000 coin now. Let's go ahead and sell this little silver ring as well. Sweet! Yeah, I really should buy some equipment. I feel like I'm pretty much rich at this point. Okay, so...
I should have been cooked.
Disappeared, Mary asked me to find her. She may be in danger. Wow. The freaking quest log doesn't even say where the hell I'm supposed to find her. Even though I know she said it's... Was it just around the jewelers or behind? I'm not sure, but yeah, if you didn't remember that, you'd be totally screwed.
Leave me alone, or I'll call the guards.
Oh, I thought I heard a noise. Let's get out of here.
Does he have her? What the hell's going on? Is this suspicious? Is this related to the disappearance? Some nonsense there, nothing special. What the hell? That was very suspicious. Oh, here we go. A book. Oh my god, 251 coin? A necklace? Take the bottle and the book. Eat the bread, because why not? Now you have found a precious offering for our god, we can perform the ritual. I will be waiting for you at the Serpent's Pillar on the fourth level at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. From there, I will lead you to the secret chambers where we will call up the 5,000 sons of the beast. Be very careful that you are not followed. Is the precious offering Shawnee? Shit. Well, it's a good thing I'm going there anyway. Of course, as far as it happening tomorrow or at 10 o'clock, I don't know what time it is. I have no concept of time, so I don't know if that matters. I'm hoping it doesn't. That is where I'm going anyway, right? The Serpent's Pillar, fourth level. Oh, no, it's not. Never mind. It is absolutely not. I've never even been to the fourth level. Nope. Okay. Well, I will find that place at some point. Whenever I can get down there. I don't even know how to get down there. Yo, so your daughter's gonna be sacrificed.
I hope you'll be able to find my little Shaney.
Oh, I know where she is. I just don't know how to get to her. Okay, well, let's buy some equipment and then head on down to the tavern. Anything new?
Do you have anything to tell me about the rituals?
Really no, Amshagar! No news!
Geez, sounds aggressive.
Oh, I know what...
Okay, I think I had my eyes on a huge shield, but I can't use it. No, I need 14 strength. I haven't leveled up again, have I? I'm actually really close, I need 578. Of course, leveling up once would not be enough. Alright, see what else is here. So, plus six. That's plus six. Yeah, so, since it's a leather armor of, leather chest piece of extra protection, it actually gives me just as much protection as this, but without the debuffs of the minus to stealth and casting and whatnot. Actually, hold on, what about the helmet? Five? Five. Yeah, nothing special. Right. Five? Yep, exactly the same, already wearing it. That's an extra one to my armor defense. Probably not worth the money. Five. Four. Nope. Two-handed axe. Okay. So no shield. 14 strength. Yep, can't use it. Short sword. I've got an axe. Damage five. Damage four. Seven. Ooh, this helmet has more armor? I think that's the helmet I sold him, actually. Which means it'd be kind of dumb to buy it. A leather helmet of great stealth. Must be one damn amazing helmet.
Anyway.
Ooh, a longsword. Okay, close combat. Ooh, requires a close combat of 40. I'm not quite there. I have 38. Strength 10. Check. Cyprian longsword of force. Oh. Wow, it adds to my strength. That looks really, really good. That thing's really good. Holy shit. That thing's amazing. The damage is 7 instead of 5. And it gives me bonuses to my stats. Only thing is, I don't quite have enough close combat to use it. Alright, I'm probably gonna get that. Not now, but when I can use it. Which will be very soon. Ah. Yeah, so 14 strength if you want to use the heaviest armor. Although, this only gives me one more armor than my freaking light leather chest. And this is plate. That makes no sense whatsoever. Maybe I shouldn't even bother getting that much strength. I heard someone say that they didn't bother putting in a huge amount of points into strength and they could get some higher level armor that I think 12 strength was enough to support. So maybe I don't. Maybe I want the shield? Nah, I'm just gonna wait a bit. I haven't even fought anything for a while, so maybe I don't even need armor to... It depends on how hard the enemies I'm going to face are going to be, and I don't know at the moment. So I'm gonna save a little bit, but I'm definitely gonna buy the sword as soon as I can, which is gonna be next time I level up.
Anyway.
Okay, back to the place. I remember. Remember. How to get back down. It's up here on the right. Can't forget about the portals, either. And then we go around, don't we? Yeah. Stupid stalactite. What was that? Holy shit, that scared me. What the fuck was that? It's one of the most terrifying noises I've ever heard, and that was really loud. The fuck? Jesus. I hear footsteps, but I don't see anything. Jesus Christ. Now, I should probably have my magic missiles all suited up and ready to go. Fortunately, I've got 3 spells down here. I should probably just dump those spells, to be honest. I do have a healing spell, though, which I'd like to keep. And then I have a poison cloud, and I think the other one's disabled trap, I think. Oh yeah, let's see if that goblin's around here, and if he still wants to kill me. Hello? He's gone. Okay, back to the bar. How do I get back to the bar? Oh shit, that entrance right there. Now that I've talked to the trolls and they're my friend, that one will allow me down to level 4. You know what? The fate of the world can wait. I'm gonna go save Shawnee. I'm itching for a fight. I can destroy this. They didn't even hit the wall. Okay. Oh, there's a switch or a lock. What if I can lockpick it?
It's impossible.
I think it means literally impossible, because it didn't even use durability.
That's not possible.
Yep, looks like it. I hear some goblins. Alright, let's see if I can use Poison Cloud. I'm not sure which one it is. That's not it. That's it. Come on, get in the poison cloud.
Die, bastard.
Damn it, no one's gonna get in the poison cloud. Alright.
Damn. Yeah. Me eat your heart.
Me cut you head off.
Alright, I wanna try magic missile. That's not it.
Stay here! Fight!
Ooh, it worked! Cool. I've got a healing spell. Which, you know, I'm just gonna burn it. Okay, good. Yeah, I just wanna free that up. Cause I want to queue up. Ooh, let's do night vision. Yeah, let's try night vision. Maybe I won't have to use a torch. Although it's probably going to make everything look sickly. Alright, what was it again? That's this one? Yeah. And then... I'm never going to remember these. Okay, yeah, oh my god, that does remove the need for a torch, but that is so unbelievably hideous, I don't even want to use it. Ugh. Let's just queue these up. Whoops. Alright. Got three of them ready to go. Probably loot their bodies, huh? Oh, wow. Whole leather chest piece. I suppose I could sell it. Might as well take it. Yeah, just gonna take all this crap. If I run out of room, I can always ditch the trash. I think there's a body over here. Hello, fellow adventurer. Looks like you were a fisherman. Oh, sweet. I just forgot how to do fire. Shit. Ah, yes.
Oh, yuck.
Wait, what was that? I saw something. A blacksmith's hammer. Oh, it's that thing? Yeah, I don't care. It is small, and I suppose I could sell it, but yeah, for some reason I just really don't care. Oh, that's a lever. What did it open? Wait, there's a lock behind it?
That's not possible.
My lockpicking skills really blow. Which is kind of weird because my actual skill in lockpicking is 40. Which is pretty good. Yeah, I think I'm going to upgrade that next. There's already a level transition. That was quick. Wait, am I going down to the fifth level? Because if I am, then that means I'm not going to find Shawnee here. So maybe I need to pick this lock, or, you know, have the key, to get to where I need to go. Let's see where this goes. Yeah, this is the fifth level. And I'm supposed to meet him on the fourth. Yeah, fourth level. The Serpent's Pillar. Hi. Are you attacking me? Oh, you are. That didn't do much. Shit.
In name of Pog. Ha! Pog will be proud.
Thank God you're so slow. Trying to hit his head.
Hog will be proud.
Oh, I'm taking a lot of damage, holy crap. Okay. There we go. Whew. A troll's amulet. Suppose I could sell those, maybe? A bejeweled longsword of extra damage. Holy crap! Whoa. I'm pretty sure that's amazing. Hold on. 8 damage compared to 5. Wow. Wow. That is really, really good. Yeah, 10 strength, 40 close combat. Oh, I can't quite use it yet. Shit. Yeah, I'm 298 away from being able to use it. Okay, well, I'm not sure if I want to continue down here or go back up and see if I can find some way to get to the, what was it, Serpent's Pillar? Yeah, Serpent's Pillar on the fourth level. I'm not sure. But regardless, this episode is running rather long, so I think I better cut it off. So I'm having a surprising amount of fun with this. It's, in some ways, it's so bad it's good. At least when it comes to the voice acting and the story. It's just completely ridiculous, but kind of in a fun way. but there's just so much in here that's actually really cool. It's a really, really cool game, and there's so many cool things to do, and I'm actually having a surprising amount of fun with it. I was worried that I wouldn't. A little bit ago, I was worried that I was going to burn out of this really fast because I started to get annoyed at not knowing where to go or what to do. But I don't know, I feel like a renewed energy to keep playing. Just all sorts of new things are popping up. The ability to make potions, sold all that stuff, found the other shopkeeper, sold that stuff, had a bunch of money, now I have something to work towards. You know, once I get my strength up and my close combat, I can start getting some weapons and some armor. And yeah, I'm having a lot of fun with it. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.